players.
Sit with Coach John Tim.
Brady Eterno!
Assistant coaches, Emily Crawford, Dan Perkins, Phil Gibson, and the head coach of the Lady Colonels, Jeff Hale.
That's the voice of Colonel Jim, Steve Town, with our starting lineups brought to you by Collier & Company Real Estate.
Officials for tonight's game, Jim Smith, the
and Michael Walker. Officials brought to you by Hometown Vision Care. Our opening tip presented by Butler's Apothecary. Count on Butler's for curbside PCR, rapid COVID test, home COVID test, as well as COVID vaccines and boosters. Butler's Apothecary, the way of pharmacy should be. Jim Schmidt moving in to throw it up here from Colonel Jim. Lady Colonels in their home whites, Union County Road, Columbia Blues. Thomas wins the tip for Henderson County into the backcourt to Caitlin Kemp.
Oh, bring it up for the Lady Colonels in this
girls' sixth district matchup tonight, presented by United Community Bank.
Gracie Risley straight away, not a chance. Caitlin just inside the arc now, picks up the handle, goes to Tims, and a cut to Tims, left hand at the glass and in.
You're a great offense there, Greg. Patience.
Thank you, Bucket. Really nice pass from Tims. Union County, very normal to pass up to him. There.
Picked up by Toombs, a steal for Henderson. Risley, a three from the left side, no good. Offensive rebound by Lacer, and she's fouled from behind. After Lady Colonel's got a steal. First foul of the ball game goes on Henderson County's Amelia Mackey.
Inbounds to Brandon and Toombs. Missed the bunny from 4 feet.
Therese couldn't finish. Rebounded by Madison Morris. Up to four, she had it knocked away by Kemp, and Kemp has a steal. She gets it off to Risley.
Now they're going to shade off on Kemp a little bit, give her that long shot. She did a good job first time. She just didn't take it.
Kemp on the right elbow, 16 feet away to Lacer, left elbow, now left wing to Risley. Gracie with the basketball, gets a screen from Thomas, now straight away for Risley, gives it up to Toombs out front. Now right side over to Kemp. Caitlin to fire a 16-footer just inside the arc. No good. Lacer's second offensive rebound. Kick out to Risley. Her three. Good. WB three for Gracie Risley. Three-pointers brought to you by a former colonel, now your local Edward Jones investment advisor, Walker Brenner. And a quick timeout for Derek Phillips and the Bravettes. 5-0 Henderson. 6:38 to go in the first here on WSON.
Littering and illegal dumping in Henderson County is at an all-time high. If you're carrying a load of trash or debris in your truck bed, be sure to tarp your load and strap everything down. And for those dumping illegally, a $500 fine will be coming your way. Henderson County Recycling and Solid Waste would like to remind county residents that free residential dumping is available at the Henderson Landfill and Transfer Station Monday through Saturday from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. Keep Henderson County litter free. This message brought to you by Henderson County Recycling and Solid Waste.
Lady Colonel's got another steal out of the timeout, but throw it right back away. The team's exchange turnovers. With 6.5 minutes gone this opening quarter and a 5-0 Henderson lead. A little floater from the left side is short, no good for Union County's Hagen. And Lady Colonel's have it going the other way.
Kemp inside the tomb, shot up, no good. Now rushed a bit from the left side.
And a rebound into the hands of Ella Goff. Pass the left baseline, over top the press, and an easy bucket up and in for Maddie Hagen. And the Bravettes are on the board. 5-2 Henderson, we played 2 minutes. Lacer to Kemp, far sideline for Caitlin Kemp. To Risley, left baseline, now Lacer coming in from the left wing. Gets it to Kemp, bobbled the pass, but now she has it controlled out high right. 5:40 to go, opening quarter, 5-2 Henderson. Kemp right wing, they give her a lot of room, kind of daring her to shoot. Now she's trying to get into the paint, cut off at the high post, brings it back out. Try to float it inside, bad pass, had it knocked away and stolen away by Morris.
Trying to run a play and nobody's moving, Jake.
Morris with the basketball, gives it up to Mackey. Dribbling into the right corner, now into the paint on Lacer. Shot up off the back rim, no good. Rebounded by Toombs for Henderson. Up the floor, Kemp, 17-footer, right elbow, good. Three different Lady Colonels have scored, 7-2 Henderson. We played 3 minutes here from Colonel Jim in Henderson. Goff, middle of the floor to Mackey. Mackey, left wing. Now into the paint, a drive, and a blocking foul called. Risley, as the foul, as going to the line for a couple free throws, is Hagen.
Kind of a tough call. Risley was standing still and got ran over.
Reese Hagen, 5'8 junior, 7 points, 4 rebounds a game. I have a couple free throws here. And this is her first. Maggie Hibbs and Lillian Goodlow in for Union County. Second free throw good for Hagen. 7-3 Henderson, 4:50 to play in this opening quarter. Caitlin Kemp, right wing for Henderson County. Now straight away. And
double foul.
Holy smokes. Yeah. That is impossible at that position on the floor.
I was in the post area. Yeah, Thomas, so on the post, so a foul going for Thomas and also on Hibbs.
If I'm not mistaken, should it be that way? Should it be a jump ball?
Not sure. Inbounds comes into Risley in the right corner, gives it up to Kemp. Right wing for Kemp. Now fires, down low. It's our 16-footer into Thomas, and Thomas foul going up as Hagen tried to come over and get a block. But foul Thomas. A couple free throws coming up for Jaree. Couple free throws coming up for Jaree Thomas. She misses her first. Thomas coming in shooting 77% from the free throw line. Struggled a little bit from the line Tuesday, uncharacteristically. This free throw up and in. 3 for Thomas. Mackey into the game. For Union County, Hagen checks out. Inbounds. Comes in for Union County, up the floor, Maggie Hibbs. Dribbles the right corner, draws a double team. Higgs trapped, tried to kick it out, and it is chased down out front by Hagen. Gives it up to Morris, right of the lane. Morris said it stripped by Risley and picked up by Lacer. Up the floor to Thomas running the floor. A nice foul up pass from Lacer, and Thomas has the bucket.
Lacer's having a great game, dude.
It is indeed. 3 rebounds already now, traveling in the backcourt. On Union County. Force a turnover.
Coming to the game tonight, be careful. We understand it's really slick out there. Drive slow. Easy on the brakes.
10-3 Henderson. Thomas in the left corner. Out front it comes to Kemp. 4 minutes to go here in the first. Now back out front to Caitlin Kemp between the circles for Henderson County. He's out close to the jump circle now. Right side to Toombs. On a cut to Thomas, right block. Back to Toombs on the right elbow. Right back down to Thomas. Turns off the glass in for the Farmers bank shot.
Wow, 2 post players kept the ball over their head and made about 3-4 passes back and forth, and easy bucket.
Farmers Bank thinks long term, always have, always will. See how that makes all the difference at 1555 South Green Street and Henderson. Hagen out high right. Gets it inside to Mackey. Little jumper from 12 won't go. Lacer, 4th rebound.
Man.
Savannah will bring it up. Good. Pass to Thomas. Bucket in the foul. A possible 3-point play.
He's got 4 rebounds and at least 3 assists, Greg.
Foul whistled on Hibbs.
And that one was pretty.
Hibbs picks up her second. And a great pass there from Lacer. And a possible three-point play for Thomas. Jury has nine already here in this opening quarter. Nine of the Lady Colonels, 14. Reed trying to complete the three-point play. It's up and in.
I'm pretty sure all points that she's got are off an assist by somebody.
15-3, Henderson. 3:10 to go, first period. Up to four, Goff at the right wing. Gets it inside to Morris. Draws a double team. Tough shot up in the lane. Won't go. Lacer rebounds for Henderson.
That's fine.
Savannah will bring it up. Has it right side. Jump stop. Now gets it off to Kemp. Kemp out high right with the basketball. Now to the right wing. Now driving right side is Caitlin. Gets to the rack, puts it up and in.
Wow.
Four for Kemp. 17-3, Henderson. 2:40 to play here in the first.
10 straight, Lady Colonels.
Inbounds comes into Morris. She had it knocked away from behind, out of bounds by Kemp. And it will stay with the Bravettes to play it in at midcourt.
Yeah, if the ball's not moving right now for the Bravettes, Greg, and if the ball's not moving, then they're going to be in trouble. Nice student section here already, Greg, for the girls game.
Yeah, homecoming night. A lot of maroon and white out there. Spirit week here at the high school. There's a shot blocked by Gibson, rebounded by Veal, just in for Henderson. With the basketball, Kemp left side. She's going to go down low to Thomas. Thomas bumped there. No foul called and give a steal to Hagan. Lady Colonel's third turnover. 17-3, Henderson, 2:05 to go here in the first. Morris on a drive left side from Hagan, and a foul on Henderson. Hagan will head to the line for two.
They got Gibson looking at it.
It is on Brooklyn Gibson. Her first, the third against Henderson. And Maddie Hagan with a couple of free throws. This one's up and in. 3 points for the senior, Maddie Hagan. She's been getting it done a long time for the Brave Vets, Scotty.
Yes, she
played
has.
Some as an eighth grader, I think.
Maybe a seventh. Her, yep. The Morse kid, too.
Yep. Second free throw, no good. Rebounded by Gibson. Picked up by Lacer. The kick. Now Veal, a three in the left corner. WB three for Mallory Veal. And a timeout, Union County. Henderson 20, Union County 4. 1:51 to go on the first. Back after this on WSON.
At Dunaway's Imperial Pharmacy, we're here for you every day with a full-service prescription center. And to make life a little easier, we accept most major credit cards and third-party insurance cards. Now, shouldn't all pharmacies be this way? Well, we are because we care. So for the things you want and the convenience you need, see Dunaway's Imperial Pharmacy today, 110 3rd Street in Henderson.
We'll be here for you.
When looking for an auto mechanic, most people look for honesty and experience. Ewing Tire delivers both and offers a wide range of automotive repair services, from brakes, alignments, shocks and struts, to tire rotations and oil changes, as well as tire sales. Ewing Tire has been in business since 1964, always providing friendly service, quality work, and products. So the next time you need tires or automotive repairs, see the team at Ewing Tire, 642 North Green Street, or call 270-826-8491.
Minute 45 to go, first quarter. Henderson on top, 20-4. Union County basketball. They try to get inside to Hagan. It's knocked away and stolen away by Caitlin Kemp. Five turnovers for the Bravettes. Kemp has her second steal. Caitlin, the senior guard, moves over to the left side. Try to go inside. Had it knocked away and saved in. A terrific play there by Union County's Madison Morris. She knocked it away and then saved it in. Her team going the way on Henderson's fourth turnover. Morris out near the jump circle. Bravettes coached by Derek Phillips in his sixth year. Hard to believe it's been 6 years. He's been the head coach Union County. Here's a three left side off the mark. No good. Rebounded by Kemp as Hagen couldn't connect.
It's their first attempt tonight.
Coach Phillips took over for Shane Smith, who took over the boys program the following year. Coach Smith now an assistant on Coach Phillips' staff. Final minute here of this first period, 20-4. Henderson on top of Union County. Beal driving from the left side, lays it up, couldn't finish. Gibson there for an offensive rebound, back up and in.
Gibson picks up the trash and puts it back home.
You know, Gibson, Scotty, the eighth grader, averages 5 points and three rebounds off the bench. Gotta love that production from your bench player.
You ain't kidding.
And Toombs, a great steal. Stole it coming in near the near sideline, saved it in to Lacer. The Gibson right side had her shot blocked. Terrific block there by Hagen, and a rebound pulled down by Goff.
Even better, she's an eighth grader. She don't turn the ball over very much either.
Yeah, Morris on that right baseline gets free into the paint, puts it up, no good. Lacer rebounds for Henderson.
Six.
And that is the end of the first quarter. After one, it is Henderson 22, Union 4. Back after this on WSON.
Have questions? We have answers. Hello, I'm Allie Brazier with the Henderson County Cooperative Extension Service. UK Extension provides practical research-based information that help people, businesses, and communities build a better future. We offer programs and assistance with agriculture and natural resources, family and consumer sciences, 4-H youth development, horticulture, and community and economic development. To see how we can help you, contact us at the Henderson County Cooperative Extension Service at 270-826-8387.
When you are ready to purchase your home, we want you to feel confident that you are choosing the most dependable bank in your area. I'm John Hobby with Farmers Bank. Farmers Bank offers mortgages for nearly every type of buyer, including purchases, refinances, consolidations, investment properties, and home equity loans. With Farmers Bank's competitive rates and quick approval turnaround times, we make your mortgage process effortless and relaxed. Farmers Bank and Trust Company on South Green Street in Henderson. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
This is Mike Hazelwood, owner of EM Fording Company. You're listening to Henderson County Basketball right here on WSON 860 AM and 96.5 FM.
Union County Basketball to start the second quarter. First quarter dominated by Henderson, 22-4. With the basketball, Morris left side gives it up to Goff out front. Now a three-point try for Hagen. Off the glass and in, the three-pointer good. From Maddie Hagen, she has six to lead the Bravettes.
She got the bank and the roll around the rim.
She did.
Usually don't get both of those on a three-point shot.
Risley had one poked away on the other end, but gets it back as Mackey on her tightly. Left side to Kemp. Caitlin to fire a three from the wing, and it's a little short, no good. Toombs on offensive rebound, right back to Kemp. 15-footer, that one's off, no good. And a rebound cleared off by Theus just into the game for Union County. Morris into the paint to Theus, right baseline. Header shot blocked by Toombs, and Toombs has the rebound. Off to Kemp here on the near sideline. Now left wing for Caitlin. Hands it off to Risley, guarded closely by Mackey. Risley dribbles to the high post. Gets to Kemp, right back to Risley. Three straight away, on the way. Good. WB three for Gracie Risley, her second. Mackey fell down on the play, leaving Risley wide open. And she drained the WB3 three-pointers brought to you by a former colonel. Now your local Edward Jones investment advisor, Walker Brenner. Now a steal by Caitlin Kemp as she knocked it away from behind of Mackey. Kemp's third steal of the ball game. And seven turnovers for the Bravettes.
Leitcher's only Lady Colonel not to score this play, but she's got six rebounds and three assists.
Risley a three out front. That one's off no good. Rebound being tapped around. Toombs has a rebound for Henderson and then is fouled. Foul whistled on Ella Goff, her first and the fifth against the Bravettes.
It's pretty good stats. All the Lady Colonels have scored but one, and she's got six rebounds and three assists.
Kemp to play it in, baseline right for Henderson. Bounces into Toombs, left side, missed it off the glass. Put back up and in, though, by Risley. Thomas.
They are killing them on the glass, Greg.
12 for Thomas. with the basketball. Morris tried to get it left side over to Hagan, and Hagan couldn't handle the pass out of bounds. Bravettes turned it over.
I think Kent might have.
Yep, for the eighth time. At least distracted her.
Yeah.
Henderson by 20 with 5:51 to go first half. Many Colonel coaches and the sport coach tonight. I haven't seen Jeff Hale in the sport coat in a long time with it being homecoming night. Coaches got on their sport coats. The ball deflected out of bounds by the Bravettes Theus. It will stay with Henderson. Wide open three for Risley on the right wing. That's her favorite spot, and she drills it.
I don't see how you leave her that open.
Her third three. She has 9 points, 30-7, Henderson. Three-pointers brought to you by a former Colonel, now your local Edward Jones Investment Advisor, Walker Bruner. Golf right side to Mackey to the glass, and a possible three-point play for Mackey. Good strong move there. Mackey's first points.
I think it would have been a charge if Risley wouldn't have came over and slapped her.
Risley hit with her second foul.
Yeah, Risley came over and slapped her right after that, though. She ran over Kemp. I think it would have been a charge.
Instead, a possible three-point play for the 5'7 sophomore, Amelia Mackey. Free throw rattles in good. 20-point Lady Colonels lead with 5:10 to go first half. Lacer to Beal in the right corner. Mallory picks up her dribble, finds Kemp, left elbow. Caitlin now into the lane, right side. Missed the lay-in, no good. Rebounded by Toons, and she had a block going back up. Up to four. Bravett tried to save it in. Toons on the floor has a steal. And Union deflects it out of bounds after that. It'll be Henderson ball. Great hustle there from Carice.
No doubt about it. Toons has got four boards.
A block shot and now a steal for Carice. Just solid. She's been solid all year, Scotty.
Yep, just consistent.
Yep.
Get same thing out of her every night.
Yep. And she has it straight away for Henderson County. Carice Toons, one dribble back over to Kemp. Kemp between the circles, Lady Colonels. The Toons on the right wing. Over to Lacer on the left side. Down low, Thomas. Kick out, Beal. 15-footer, right elbow. A little strong, no good. Rebound kept alive by Beal. Picked it by Toons. Somehow got it to Thomas. Her shot, no good. And I think an over-the-back foul on Union County. I think Beal got another rebound there. She did. Foul goes on Mackey, her second. Annie Bevan into the game for the first time for Union County. As Kemp gets into Thomas out at the high post. Reed's going to hand it off to Lacer now, right back to Kemp. Kemp drives in the paint, kind of stumbles, tries to kick it back out and does to Lacer. Now right side back over to Kemp. She'll come back middle of the floor now to reset. 20-point Lady Colonels lead, 4 minutes to go, first half. Long two for Gibson won't go. And a rebound into the hands of Bevan. Morris in the basketball. Coach Derek Phillips wanted her to slow it down a little bit.
Yeah, playing fast is definitely not to their advantage.
Left side with it, Morris. And he gives it up straight away to Hagan. Now driving to the right side. Maddie Hagan, and a reaching foul called on Veal for Henderson, her first. Five against Lady Colonels. Risley into the game as Veal checks out. Already to 10. Lady Colonels by 20, 3:31 to go in his first half. Inbound
Hutchins is still out. Brooke from Gibson, good defense there. Throwing away the inbound pass. Up before to Kemp.
Kemp had her shot blocked. And it's out of bounds. It will stay with Henderson. I think it was Hagen who got that blocked shot. Gill returns as Risley checks out for Henderson. Gibson knocked out front to Veal, who chases down a loose ball. And now Savannah Lacer to Brooklyn Gibson on the left side. Thomas going to fire a three straight away and hit. Jaree Thomas with 15. Doesn't take a lot of them. She is now 3 of 9 from three this season with that make. With the basketball, Hagen on the left side gives it up to Morris out front. 33-10, Henderson with 2:50 to go in the half. Bevan straight away with it to Hagen. Reese Hagen bounces over to Morris, fights through a screen, 16-footer straight away. No good, rebounded by Thomas for Henderson. Off to Lacer, Savannah, right side to Kemp. Inside Thomas, 8-footer, middle of the lane, no good. Rebounded by Gibson, and Gibson had it knocked away after she had the rebound, turns it over. Right side, Maddie Hagen hands it off to Morris. 2:10 to play here in the half. Bevan, left side to Hagen. Maddie Hagen from left to right, puts it up, no good. Got to the rim but couldn't finish, but she'll head to the line for two after the foul goes on Henderson's Jaree Thomas, her second. A couple Lady Colonel starters now. Tyler and Risley each with two fouls. Here with 2:06 to go in the first half. A couple of free throws coming up for Hagen. Maddie's first up and in. 7 points for Maddie Hagen to lead the Bravettes. Second free throw coming up. And Hagen's got a boat. She has 8. Lacer to Veal into the left corner for Henderson County. Lady Colonel's right to left here in this first half. Try to get inside to Gibson, and she is fouled by Reese Hagen. It's kind of leaning over Gibson, trying to deny that pass into the post. And it's going to be a 1-1 for the eighth grader, Brooklyn Gibson. Gibson, a 73% free throw shooter. And it rattles into free throw. She'll get the bonus shot. Lady Colonel, Scotty, as a team, pretty good. They shoot 70% from the free throw line as a team. That's a good number.
Yeah. And if you want to go to state, you're going to have to shoot that good.
And Gibson hits them both here. 4 points for Gibson off the bench, 35-12 Henderson.
That lost to Apollo ever since. Lady Colonels have been on a tear, Greg.
Nice pass up the floor and a layup easy for Maddie Hagen.
You're going to have that every now and then.
Really nice look there for Paige Stewart, who had just checked into the game. Toombs with it for Henderson County. Now to Brooklyn Gibson. Right away for Gibson to Veal on the right wing. On a cut, Lacer to Kemp. Kemp, a little runner from 10, right of the lane, no good. Got her own rebound. And then had her shot blocked and rebounded by Hagen. Off to Morris. It's Derek Phillips yelling, be patient, with the basketball in the left corner. His Stewart spins out. Now a deep three out front for Hagen.
Wow.
Maddie Hagen, no good. Rebound chased down by Lacer.
Got a quick release on that one.
Field to the right corner for Henderson. One bounce for Mallory. Now gets it to Lacer. Lacer over Toombs on the left side. Gibson on the cut, puts it up, and she's fouled while ahead of the line for two. Didn't appear to be a lot there, but
no, I was a nickel
dammer. Gibson going to get the benefit, go to the line for a couple as the foul goes on Madison Morris, her first.
Yeah, I didn't see nothing there.
Free throw for Brooklyn is good. She has 5 off the bench. That's her averages. Averages 5 and 3, and she has that right now here in this final minute of the first.
Almost 5 of 6 from the line early. We got about 25 rebounds.
Second free throw coming up. That one's off, no good. Rebound pulled down by Reese Hagan for Union County.
They are completely controlling the glass.
36-14, Henderson. With the basketball, right corner, Morris, guarded closely by Kemp. Morris on the baseline. Now a kick out three on the way. Good. Three-pointer from the left side. Good for Maddie Hagan. 13 in his first half for Hagan. 10 of them here in the second quarter. Trying to keep the Bravettes in it. Final 10 seconds of the half. Lady Colonels on top, 36-17. Kemp, 16 feet away, gives to Toombs, a long two. Off the mark, no good. And a rebound pulled down by Morris. That is the end of the first half. Lady Colonels up 36-17. Scott Stone with Jeff Hale.
Coach, on the leisure first half.
Trying to let him back there and make the three on this right there. Giving up a couple threes, we shouldn't give up, and turn the ball.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck, Sam.
That's the head coach of the Lady Colonels, Jeff Hale. Lady Colonels go into the locker room with a big lead. It's Henderson County 36, Union County 17. Our game tonight here on WSON being brought to you by United Community Bank. With six locations in Union and Webster counties to serve you, visit ucbwest.com for more and to find a location nearest you. United Community Bank, making a difference at home. Stay tuned for Colonels at the half. It's Henderson County on top of Webster County, 36-17 here on WSON.
Did you know that reading for 20 minutes a day exposes a person to 1.8 million words a year? Early exposure to language is the greatest factor in language development, and listening to other people read aloud is an important part of learning to read. Hello, my name is Megan Mortis, Director of Public Information for Henderson County Schools. Research shows that reading with a child every day from birth through elementary school has a lasting, positive outcome for children, families, and communities. We encourage our families to pick up a book and read together today. Inspire a love of reading, hashtag HCS Reads.
One size fits all. That may be all right for an adjustable belt or cheap sunglasses, but when it comes to your financial needs, no one wants a one-size-fits-all strategy. Hi, I'm Ryan Wilkie, your local Edward Jones financial advisor. My most important goals are yours. That's why I take the time to understand your needs so I can recommend personalized strategies with your goals in mind. Contact me today, 826-5993. Knowing you, that's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing. Member SIPC.
Uncle Larry sells cars, Uncle Larry buys cars.
Wait, Uncle Larry buys cars?
Oh yeah, Ivan Chrysler buys cars from people every day. That's right, folks. If you have a car, truck, van, or SUV that you want to sell, bring it on in.
Ivan's ready to pay big for your vehicle.
If you're ready to sell, Uncle Larry's ready to buy.
Bring in the vehicle you're ready to sell today.
Ivan Chrysler and Henderson.
Don't fuss, don't holler. Come get top dollar.
Fix up your home with Heritage. Our home improvement financing options can help you change your home now and pay for it over time. Upgrade your home. Make home repairs. Remodel a kitchen. Create a man cave. Remodel your bath. Whether it's a small weekend project or a large renovation, Heritage Federal Credit Union can help you finance your improvements today. Fix up your home with Heritage.
Some restrictions apply. Rates, terms, conditions are subject to change. Not always insured. Credit to you at Equal Housing Lender. Go to hfc.info for details about credit costs and terms.
Colonels at the half. The Henderson County High School basketball halftime show here on WSON is next. Being presented by Classic Automotive and Collision Center. Classic Automotive, where you're driving home their reputation. Stay tuned for halftime scoring and stats on Colonels at the Half, presented by Classic Automotive and Collision Center.
If you've been deer hunting with your F-150, then you need to see Cliff at Classic Automotive and Collision Center. Cliff can remove the antlers and make your vehicle look like a new one. Cliff Williams, with over 25 years' experience, employs a certified staff, provides free towing, and friendly personal service. And remember, it's your choice where you get your vehicle repaired. So for expert auto body repair, see Cliff at Classic Automotive and Collision Center at 1215 Lower 2nd Street under the overpass, or call 270-826-7979.
You're listening to Henderson County High School Lady Colonel Basketball right here on 860 AM and 96.5 FM. WSON, Henderson, Kentucky.
Welcome to Colonels at the Half here on WSON, brought to you by Classic Automotive and Collision Center. At the half, the Henderson County Lady Colonels lead the Union County Bravettes 36-17. Colonels at the Half, again, brought to you by Classic Automotive and Collision Center. Taking a look at first half scoring, the Lady Colonels outscored Union County 22-4 in the opening quarter. Bravettes kept it tight, though, in the second. Lady Colonels outscored them 14-13. Scoring in the first half, 13 points for Maddie Hagan to lead the way for Union County, 3 points for Amelia Mackey, and a point for Reese Hagan. For Henderson County, 15 points for Jaree Thomas, 9 for Gracie Risley, 4 for Caitlin Kemp, 3 for Mallory Veal, and 5 points for Brooklyn Gibson. Savannah Lucer did not score in that first half, but had a team-best 7 rebounds for the 5'4 junior. 36-17, Lady Colonels up 19 at the break. We'll come back with a look at halftime team stats next, brought to you by Classic Automotive and Collision Center.
Stop by Classic Automotive and Collision Center and take a look at their new office and auto body repair shop with state-of-the-art technology highlighted by the Garmat Chinook Spray Booth. Family-owned and operated for 40 years. Certified, experienced staff, and guarantee a quality repair. Remember, it's your choice, not the insurance company, where you get your vehicle fixed. Classic Automotive and Collision Center, 203 Heilman Avenue under the 2nd Street overpass.
Matt Duncan with Farmers Bank. You're listening to Henderson County Basketball right here on 860 AM, 96.5 FM, and WSONradio.com.
Welcome back to Colonels at the Half, brought to you by Classic Automotive and Collision Center. Let's see who's crashing the glass here in this opening half. Crashing the Glass, brought to you by Classic Automotive and Collision Center. Remember, it's your choice, not the insurance companies, where you get your vehicle fixed after a crash. Classic Automotive, where you're driving home their reputation. It was all Lady Colonels on the boards in that opening half as Henderson out-rebounded Union County 23-9 in that opening half of play. Lady Colonels plus 14 on the boards. Henderson had 5 turnovers. Union County with 10. From three-point range, the Lady Colonels were 3 of 8, 37%. Union 2 of 4, 50% three-point shooting. Both teams were 5 of 7 from the free throw line, good for 71%. Lady Colonels on top, 36-17. D. Patrick Ford presents our keys to the game. Scotty, how do the keys look here at halftime with Henderson up 19?
We're looking pretty good. We're turning them over pretty good. We wanted to control the glass because we had a big size advantage. We're killing them on the glass. I mean, Lacer, one of the smaller players on the team, she's got 6. So we're doing a good job on the glass and, you know, running our offense. And took us a few seconds there to get used to what they were doing man-to-man, and they were sagging back on Kemp. But Kemp ended up just taking her time and not taking too many shots. And she ended up scoring 4 points and had 2 or 3 assists. So, you know, once we settled down and saw what they were doing, we were A-OK.
36-17, your halftime score, our keys of the game, and a look at them here at the half, brought to you by D. Patrick Ford here on WSON. We'll keep it right here for a minute. Scott Stone to get a brief word with Union County head coach Derek Phillips as the Bravettes coming out here for the second half. Much more competitive for the Bravettes there in that second quarter after Henderson jumped out to a 22-4 lead. The Bravettes and Henderson played a tight second quarter, 14-13. Henderson had the edge, but the Bravettes right with him. Scott Stone with head coach Derek Phillips.
Coach, just your observation on the first half.
First quarter got us, you know, they made a big run right out the gate, and that was something that we talked about. We couldn't happen. I'm proud of my kids in the second quarter. We fought back. You know, we lost that quarter by 1, I think, but we shrunk the gap, and our girls are playing hard, and I got to be happy with that.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck second half.
That's the head coach of the Union County Bravettes, Coach Derek Phillips. There you go. That's a story we have as well, kind of just a tale of two quarters. And Henderson's big early lead holds. They're up 19 at the half. Our keys to the game, again, brought to you by D. Patrick Ford. We'll hear from them be back with the second half. Is that do it for Colonels at the half? Brought to you by Classic Automotive and Collision Center. Again, your halftime score, Henderson 36, Union County 17 here on WSON.
Your way is the D. Patrick Ford way. Take advantage of unheard-of deals and incentives and buy it your way. Stop by our clean, comfortable showroom or shop online at dpatrickford.com. Call, text, or video chat directly with our D. Patrick Ford professionals. Test drive and take delivery at your home. D. Patrick Ford delivers. Now is the right time to save on a new F-150, Edges, or Escapes. D. Patrick Ford is a better vehicle buying experience. Your way is the D. Patrick Ford way. Family-owned and community-driven since 1934.
This is Ryan Wilkie with Edward Jones. You're listening to Henderson County Basketball here on 860 AM, 96.5 FM, and WSONradio.com.
.36-17 as we get set to start the second half of play. Our game tonight here on WSON being presented by United Community Bank of West Kentucky with six locations in Union and Webster counties to serve you. Visit ucbwest.com for more and to find a location nearest you. United Community Bank, making a difference at home. Stay tuned here on WSON. We'll have the second half of the doubleheader for you tonight, the boys game, and it'll be the Braves and the Colonels, and I think we're going to be near capacity for that one, Scotty. They are still fouling in for what should be a very entertaining boys game.
And it's still 45 minutes away.
Pass deflected out of bounds by the Bravettes, Maddie Hagan, as Henderson gets the basketball to start this second half.
I mean, there's not very many seats left, Greg. We're not even 7 o'clock yet. This is going to be a fun night.
Got the homecoming ceremonies as well, so that would always bring some more folks out. Kemp driving for the right side, put it up. May have been partially blocked. Rebound into the hands of Madison Morris for the Bravettes. The Bravettes point guard, Morris, 5'8 junior, brings it up. And a whistle.
Something.
And
mask.
Mask was off of the floor. Official notice that and stop play.
I wonder if it was his.
I wonder. Okay, he put it in his pocket. He didn't just throw it away. With the basketball, the Bravettes, Morris. It's a screen out front from Goff. Right side with the basketball. Reese Hagan. Now it comes back to Morris. Out to the jump circle. Looks over at head coach Derek Phillips for instructions. Coach Phillips in his sixth year with the Bravettes. Jeff Hale in year number 36 with the Lady Colonels. Coach Hale nearing 800 wins. And they'd like to get that early next season. 36-17. Lady Colonels on top. And here's a steal by Savannah Lacer. Knocked it away from Mackey. To Kemp on the left wing. Out near the middle of the circle for Caitlin. Toombs right side. Picks up her dribble. Now Lacer straight away. She'll fire a three and hit. WB three for Savannah Lacer. Her first points. 3-pointers brought to you by a former Colonel, now your local Edward Jones investment advisor, Walker Bruner. Up the floor, Mackey, trying to run it for the Bravettes. Gets it right side to Goff, trying to go back to Mackey, but had it thrown away by Thomas for Henderson. Lacer to Toombs, 17-footer straight away, off no good. And a rebound foul against Union County. As Thomas had that board, she was fouled from behind by Hagan. Lady Colonels will get it in underneath their own basket. Baseline right. Kemp to play it in. Caitlin gets it out front to Risley. Risley a quiet 9 points in that first half. She knocked down a couple threes. Three threes. Toombs at the high post. Had it knocked away, but right to Risley. Down low, they get it into Kemp. She can't finish from 6 feet. Rebound loose on the floor to be a jump ball as Goff and Toombs are tied up, and it will go with the Bravettes. Inbounds comes in, and a ball at midcourt deflected out of bounds by Risley as they try to get up to Mackey. And Union County will get it in at midcourt. Not many seats remain, folks. If you want to get in for a homecoming festivities between games and the boys' game to follow, you better make your way to the Colonel Gym. Be careful of driving, though. Understand,
yes,
the roads.
Slowly.
Roads can be a little slick. Left side, Moore is firing a three from the wing. That one's off, no good. Rebound being tapped around, controlled by Toombs for Henderson. Up the floor to Kemp. Kemp, a three on two. Floater, middle lane, no good. Caitlin got her own rebound. Puts it back up, and that one's no good. And then a rebound foul against Union County over the back of Toombs. That one goes on Reese Hagan, her third. And Union County's going to take a timeout. 5:24 to go in the third quarter. Henderson 39, Union 17. Back after this on WSON.
This is Lori Hesley and Rachel Austin with E.M. Ford & Company. We are not just a commercial insurance agency, but a leader in personal lines insurance. If you are impacted by AAA's decision not to continue writing auto and home insurance in Kentucky, we have a solution for you.
As an independent agency, we represent many companies and will work hard to find the right fit for your family and your budget. We are proud to announce that we're now offering a Progressive Home product as well. Call us for a quote today.
E.M. Ford & Company on the Strip in Henderson.
.24 to go in the third quarter, 39-17. Henderson on top of Union County here in this girls' sixth district matchup tonight from Henderson. Our game tonight here on WSWing being brought to you by United Community Bank. Tonight's game sponsor, United Community Bank of West Kentucky, with six locations in Union and Webster counties to serve you. Visit ucbwest.com for more and to find a location nearest you. United Community Bank, making a difference at home. Jim Schmidt, kind of lead officials, coming over to the official scorers table before we got things back into play here. Not sure what that's about. I think maybe seating. There's a person in a wheelchair. They need to maybe get moved in an end zone that was kind of blocking where the players and the officials would be running. So I want to make sure that young lady is safe and the officials as well.
Yeah, we don't want her to get ran over.
Yep. Well, they're going to get her taken care of. Packed house, so a lot of places she could go.
No doubt.
39-17, and Kemp had the inbounds pass stolen away by Morris. Henderson's sixth turnover. Morris gives it up left side to Maddie Hagan. Now a three-point try for Mackey. Good. Amelia Mackey with six. 39-20. And now Henderson will take a timeout. 5:02 to go in the third. It's the Lady Colonels by 19. Back after this on WSON.
When an auto accident happens, you want to make sure you get the best possible repairs. And at Team Collision, you get just that. Team Collision Center provides quality products and service, certified technicians, thorough inspections, lifetime warranties, and help with insurance claims and car rentals. If you do have an auto accident, don't let your repair be one too. Experience the best. Team Collision Center, 2171 South Green Street in Henderson. Or call 869-8326. That's 270-869-8326. Team.
.39-20, Lady Colonels with the lead and the basketball with 5:02 to go in the third quarter.
It's crazy. It's jammed, packed in here, and I'm cold a little bit. So is the bookkeeper, so just ain't me.
With the basketball, Thomas out at the high post. Bounces to Kemp on the left side. Kemp lost it momentarily, has it back. Now Toombs just inside the arc, and a whistle and a foul away from the ball. Legal screen on Lacer. First foul on Lacer.
Henderson won the first quarter by 18, won the second quarter by one. And right now they're even in the first 3:15.
Yeah, Coach Phillips said it was all about that first quarter, but there's a fight in the second quarter. Inbound pass comes in. They get it to Morris across far sideline. Morris being double teamed. It's to Mackey. Now on the right side with the basketball is Hibbs. Back to Mackey. Left side for her into the left corner. Pick it up the dribble, Goff. To Mackey out high left. Now to the hands of Morris near the jump circle. 4:15 to play in the third. Henderson by 19. Right side with the basketball, Hibbs. It's on the floor, lost it momentarily. Now has it back out high right. On a handoff to Morris and a timeout, Union County. 4:05 to go in the third. It is Henderson 39, Union County 20. Timeout here on WSON.
If you've struggled with losing weight but nothing seems to help, weight loss surgery might be right for you. Owensboro Health Surgical Weight Loss Center has helped hundreds of patients lose weight and gain healthier and happier lives. With the help of our bariatric surgeon, Dr. Ravi Alapati, our team helps patients through each step of their weight loss journey. Get started today by watching our free online seminar at owensborohealth.org/bestself.
The new year is here, and it's time to make a winning deal at Henderson Chevrolet Buick GMC.
We're making the deals with $500 customer cash on select new vehicles.
Save big on pre-owned, like a 2017 GMC Terrain for $299 a month or a 2021 Chevy Silverado for $599 a month.
Buy new roads or cross that money-saving bridge to make a winning deal only at Henderson Chevrolet Buick GMC and HendersonChevrolet.com. Payments plus tax, title, and fees, 4.5% for 96 months with approved credit.
.405 to go, third quarter. Henderson County 39, Union County 20. Union County basketball out of the timeout. Brave Vetches have one timeout remaining. And 5-second count on Hagen out of the timeout. She couldn't get the inbounds in. Good defense from the Lady Colonels. 13 turnovers for the Brave Vets tonight.
Ouch. That hurt.
Yeah.
Out of the timeout.
Really frustrating as a coach there. You feel like you kind of wasted that timeout.
Oh, my gosh. Well, you know, it wasn't kind of. You wasted it.
39-20. Lacer a three from the right side. That one's off. No good. Rebound into the hands of Morris for the Bravettes. Left side with the basketball, Hagen. Now Goff straight away to Morris on the right side. On the screen from Goff. Hibbs with it. Left side to Mackin. With Kemp on her. Now Goff between the circles. Got to bounce it right side, and Thomas got the steal, and Goff fouled her. Nice play by Jaree Thomas, the junior. Jaree's third steal of the night.
Colonel's defense has been fine. Just no offense here in the third quarter. Just a field goal, and that is it. Literally a field goal. In football, that is.
That was a Lacer three. 3:20 to go in the third, 39-20. Kemp with the basketball is holding it, needs to get it to somebody. She picked up her dribble. Now Grizzly comes out.
Really, she didn't have to. Wasn't it by Gardner?
Driving in, Lacer had her shot blocked. Lacer tried to save it in on the baseline. It's loose, and that is out of bounds off of Henderson. It does go to the Brave X. .39-20, been stuck on this score for a while. Just under 3 minutes to go in the third. Henderson by 19 after Lady Colonels jumped out to a 22-4 lead after the first quarter, and the two teams played within a point of each other in the second. And it's
ice cold.
Competitive again here in the third. Each team with 3 points. Here's a steal out front by Risley. Risley going to the rack, puts it up, no good, but draws the foul, and Gracie will head the line for a couple free throws.
Reminds me of the whole game the other night of the Webster and Henderson boys.
Mackey hit with her third foul for Union County. Grizzly with 10 points, first free throws of the night, and she knocks it down. Gracie, a 73% free throw shooter. Camille Theus into the game as Goff checks out for Union County. Second free throw coming up, and that one's off, no good, and a rebound chased down by Theus. 20-point Henderson lead with 2.5 minutes to go in the third. Right side with the basketball, Morris dribbles to the baseline. And not sure, still a block. I was still, completely still, blocked. Still, thank still. You, Scott. Official right in front of me. Stolen away by the Lady Colonels with the basketball. To Kemp in the left corner. Kemp, a little floater. A lot of contact there. No whistle. Lacer has a rebound for Henderson. Tied up. It will stay with Henderson.
I'm surprised Lacer just didn't shoot that three, Rick. He was open. She can make that shot all day.
Savannah Lacer, 3 points, 8 rebounds, and 2 steals.
And at least 3 assists.
And 3 of her 8 rebounds, including that last one, have come on the offensive end.
And the 1 assist was a no-look pass for an and-one that looked beautiful. Oh, goodness.
Inbounds comes to Thomas. Now straight away to Lacer. Fakes the three. Kick out to Veal. Veal driving in from the right side. Lays it up and in.
Yes. Sharpshooter taking it to the rack, Greg.
Mallory with 5 off the bench. Lady Colonel by 22. 2:05 to go here in the third quarter. Devin trying to get it on the right corner to Hibbs. Deflected out of bounds by Thomas. And it will stay with Union County. Stewart coming into the game, along with Mackey returning for Union County, as Maddie Hagen checks out and Maggie Hibbs to the bench. 42-20 Henderson, exactly 2 minutes to play in the third. Ravets to play it in, baseline right. Morris with the basketball out near the jump circle. And a near steal from Kemp. Now, they may get Kemp with a foul here. They do. Caitlin Kemp try to jump in front of a pass in front of Mackey, but hit with a foul. Kemp picks up her first.
Like the grist play, though. You get regional tournament. They ain't going to call that.
42-20. Henderson, a minute 40 to go here in the third. Devin with the basketball left side. A couple dribbles. Picks up her dribble now.
She can be aggressive. It's a third quarter and she had no fouls.
Yep. Morris dribbles to the right baseline, cut off by Lacer. Now to Stewart. The ball deflected out of bounds by Henderson. It will stay with the Bravettes. They'll play it in. And a free throw line extended on the far sideline. Bounce comes out front. Morris at the jump circle, guarded by Lacer. Left side to Bevin. Bevin dribbles to the right wing, gives it up to Stewart out high right. Now straight away to Theus. Now Morris, try to go back inside to Theus. Theus has it and then lost it underneath the basket. Gets it right side to Stewart. Her shot blocked by Thomas. Out of bounds, it will stay with Union County.
It's just been a bad quarter of basketball.
4-3. Reese Hagen returns for Union County as Theus checks out.
4-3, and we're almost done with it.
22-point Henderson lead with a minute 7 to go here in the third. Bevin to play it in baseline right and threw it over the head of Mackey. Out of bounds, Henderson's ball. Turnover number 17 on the night for the Bravettes. Hibbs going to return for Union County as Mackey checks out. Also, Hagen in. Hagen for Hagen. Maddie's in for Reese. 65 seconds to play, third quarter, 42-20. Henderson by 22. Grizzly, six-footer, middle of the lane. Roseanne Good on a nice cut from Grizzly. She has a dozen. The Colonels push it to 24. With the basketball driving left side, Maddie Hagen gets the right, couldn't finish, rebounded by Kemp. A strong rebound from Caitlin. Wants to go coast to coast off to Veal, who's hammered. And Mallory Veal will head of the line for two. This one goes on the Bravettes, Bevin. And a couple free throws here for Mallory Veal, a 70% free throw shooter. Veal's first is no good. 5 points off the bench for Mallory tonight. Mackey and Hagen return as Bevin and Stewart go to the bench for Union County. Second free throw coming up for the 5'8 junior, Mallory Veal. She got that one. Six for Veal off the bench. Mighty Colonels have pushed it to 25 with 38 seconds to play in the third. Middle of the floor of the basketball, Mackey. Just in front of the jump circle for Union County. Lacer comes out on her. Mackey hands it off to Morris out high left. Veal out on Morris. Now right side it goes to Maddie Hagen. Mackey, top of the key, driving left side. Scoops it over to Hibbs in the corner. Draws a double team and a whistle and a foul on Henderson. This is Lady Colonel's third team foul. As this one goes on Jeree Thomas, her third personal foul. Carice Toombs into the game for Henderson as Thomas checks out. It'll be Morris to play it in down in the left corner for the Bravettes. Morris looking, still looking, bounces it in to Hagen, right back to Morris. Now Mackey, 12-footer, middle of the lane, good. Amelia Mackey with eight. Final second of the third. Risley just crossed half court, shot up, no good. And that is the end of the third quarter. After three, Henderson 45, Union 22. Back after this on WSON.
Did you know litter cleanup costs the U.S. an estimated $11.5 billion each year, and businesses pay $9.1 billion of the cleanup cost, or about 80%. Litter reduces the value of real estate, deters a customer from entering a business, or a new employer from locating to a community. Over one-third of business development officials say that litter impacts a decision to locate to a community. Be on the lookout for litter around your property and neighborhood. Be classy, not trashy. This message from Henderson County Recycling and Solid Waste.
At Dunaway's Imperial Pharmacy, home health care is an important part of our business because it's important to you. So when your doctor says it's okay to convalesce at home, we'll be here for you with wheelchairs, crutches, canes, walkers, incontinent, ostomy, colostomy, and diabetic supplies, and counseling. When home health care is a prescription, Dunaway's Imperial Pharmacy is here for you. 110 3rd Street in Henderson.
We'll be here for you.
Dunaway's Imperial Pharmacy.
You're listening to Henderson County High School Lady Colonel Basketball right here on 860 AM and 96.5 FM. WSON, Henderson, Kentucky.
Start of the fourth quarter, Henderson County 45, Union County 22. Our game tonight here on WSON being brought to you by United Community Bank. United Community Bank of West Kentucky with six locations in Union and Webster counties to serve you. Visit ucbwest.com for more and to find the location nearest you. United Community Bank, making a difference at home. Bravettes with the basketball to start this fourth quarter with Henderson on top by 23. Here's a steal by Savannah Lacer on the far sideline, and Lacer has a layup on the other end.
She's done a little bit of everything tonight.
She has, yeah. 5 points, eight rebounds, and three steals for Lacer. She's been great. Now foul on Henderson against the Union pressure, and it's whistled on Kemp. Two on Kemp. Fourth against Henderson. As Reese Hagen will look to play it again against the full court pressure. Hagen right underneath the basket, now gets it in to Mackey. Back to Hagen, up the floor to Morris, far sideline for her. Now comes middle of the floor, guarded by Lacer. With 7:20 to go in the game, a 25-point Henderson lead, 47-22. Driving left side is Morris, shot up no good, but draws the foul, and Morris will head to line for two. After Risley whistled for the foul, coming over trying to help. Three on Risley. Morris looking for her first points. Averages 13 a game, but has been shut out here tonight. But she hits her first free throw. 47-23. Second free throw is good. Got them both. 47-24. Lady Colonels in front by 23 with 7:05 to go in the game. Kemp, left side to Veal from the corner. Now gets it into the hands of Caitlin Kemp out near the jump circle. Kemp directing some traffic out front. Has it between the circles. Lady Colonel point guard goes over to the right side. Got a lob inside to Thomas. Good catch from Jaree. Puts it up. No good. Missed it. Got her own rebound back up. No good. And her other rebound chased down by Mackey for Union County.
And got a rebound and just kind of threw it back up there like a dart. Take your time. You got huge size in it.
With the basketball is Hagen. Reese bounces it to Maddie. Maddie Hagen on the right elbow, and it's stolen away by Caitlin Kemp. Kemp all alone on the other end, lays it up and in. Still on a basket for Kemp. Six for Kemp. And loose ball to inbounds, and it's stolen away by Risley. Lady Colonels another steal. Kemp, 15-footer at the free throw line. Good.
Watch out. She starts making her shots.
Eight for Kemp. As the Lady Colonels have pushed it to 27, and now Union County throws the inbounds pass away out of bounds. Three consecutive turnovers for the Bravettes. 21 now for the game. Hagen to come out. Reese Hagen. As Goff returns to the Bravettes. Kemp to trigger it in for the Lady Colonels. Finds Risley, three right wing, just off, no good. And a rebound into the hands of Goff. Off to Morris.
6 of 12 from three-point range.
That's very good, 50%. Morris, off-balance jumper in the paint, rattles off, no good. Rebound out of bounds, last touch by Henderson to stay with Union County. Morris to play it in, baseline left. Try to get into Goff, deflected out of bounds by Thomas, and the Bravettes try to get it in once more. Risley out of the game as Brooklyn Gibson in for Henderson. Morris trying to get it in and does on the left wing to Mackey. Guarded by Kemp. Goff from the right side now on Thomas. Shot no good, but draws the foul on Thomas. And Goff will have a couple free throws as Thomas picks up her fourth personal foul. Couple free throws coming up for Ella Goff. Misses her first, 5'10 sophomore. Thomas coming out of the game with the four fouls as Toombs is in. Lacer out as Anna Kemp's in for the first time. Second free throw coming up for Goff. She got that one, her first point. Quick turnaround for the Lady Colonels. Will be back in action tomorrow, 1:30. Against Owensboro Senior on the road. The pass went through the hands of Gibson, kind of bobbled away after it was tipped by Union County. Lady Colonels turn it over. On the other end, Morris is in the paint. Hits to Hibbs, a runner from 10, no good. Hibbs got her own rebound, back up and in. Maggie Hibbs has her first points off the offensive glass. 5 minutes to play in the fourth. Henderson 51, Union County 27. Kemp between the circles. Right side to Anna Kemp. Back to Caitlin Kemp. 4:40 remaining. Colonels and Braves coming up after this one. Can't wait, Scotty. That's going to be a big one. That should be. That's a big-time district game coming up. Union likes to score it, too, man.
Where that
They're
game?
Over there. They scored in the 70s.
Where that one's in the driver's seat.
They are.
We'll be 2-0.
Foul away from the ball on Henderson, an illegal screen called against Carice Toombs.
Wow, didn't see that one.
Braves and Colonels coming up next. Stay with us if you're watching the video feed tonight. We'll have the halftime ceremony. Nice cut and a possible three-point play for Maddie Hagan, who has 15. She was fouled by the Lady Colonels. That one whistled against Henderson's Risley. Her fourth. Hagan, possible three-point play. Risley comes out as Lacer returns. Goff going to come back in for Union County as she checks in for Hagan. Free throw up and in. 16 for Hagan. Henderson, though, by 21. 4:10 to play. Jumper for Veal. Left baseline, no good. Rebounded by Hibbs, or do we have a jump ball? Jump ball between Thomas and Hibbs. The arrow stays with Henderson. Henderson ball. I think the Brave Vet fans thought that whistle came a little early for a jump ball as Hibbs looked like she had it secured, but a jump ball called and arrow stays with Henderson. 51-30 with 4 minutes to play. Kemp to Toombs. Thomas now 17-footer, good. 17 for Jaree Thomas to lead all scorers. 3:40 to go, first half, 53-30. Hibbs with the basketball right side, and she's fouled by Veal on a nice pass up the floor from Maddie Hagan to find Hibbs. As Veal hit with her second foul, a couple free throws coming up from Maggie Hibbs, 5'5 freshman. Hibbs free throw up and banked it in from the free throw line. However, you can get it in there.
No doubt.
Not sure if Maggie meant it to work, but it worked.
Still count for the same amount
of
points.
It does.
That'd be something if they only give you half of a point. You bank it in. You bank a two in, you get one.
I think she does bank them in. She did them both. Same thing. Perfect. Why not?
If you bank a three in, you only get a point and a half.
We were talking about those kind of different free throws in our last broadcast. So
yeah,
I'll
no doubt.
Shoot them differently. One-handed, the grannies, whatever works.
Intentionally banking them?
Intentionally banking them. There's a loose ball down on the floor to be a Union County ball on a turnover from Henderson as Morris and Toombs are tied up on the floor with a loose ball. 10 turnovers for Henderson. 53-32 Henderson, 3:20 to go here in the fourth.
Coaching staff not very happy. Entry pass has not been very good after the first.
Toombs knocks the inbounds pass right back out of bounds as Hagan tried to play it in.
Oh, my.
And right to Mallory Veal. Lady Colonels with the steal. Veal now will fire a three in the corner. No good. Rebound being tapped around, and it's controlled by Reese Hagan for the Bravettes. Up the floor to Morris right side. Back and down on Veal. And it's shot up, no good, and travel, yeah.
Good call.
23 turnovers for the Bravettes tonight. Oh, 21-point Lady Colonels lead, 53-32. Really, Scotty, it's the first quarter. It's been a difference in this game.
Yep, can't win in first, but you sure can lose it.
We said that before.
Union lost it in the first.
22-4. Veal in the paint, puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Toombs, back up and off the glass and in for the Farmers Bank shot for Carice Toombs, who has 7. Farmers Bank thinks long term, always have, always will. See how that makes all the difference at 1555 South Green Street in Henderson. Foul in the backcourt on Lacer. And it'll be 2 free throws on the other end, 10 team fouls. Union County just 5 fouls, but that is 10 on Henderson, so the Bravettes will shoot 2 free throws this final 2:42 of the game. as Morris heading to the line, where she is 2 of 2 tonight. Free throw off, no good for Morris. As Theus and Goff return for Union County, Hibbs and Reese Hagen check out. Allison Wright out in for the first time for Henderson. She's in for the senior Toombs. Also, Shaylin Sprinkles into the game for the first time in for Lacer. We'll talk to Savannah Lacer on our post-game show. 5 points, 8 rebounds, 3 steals for Lacer tonight. Second free throw coming up good. 3 for Morris, all from the line. Henderson by 22, 55-33 with 2:38 to go in the fourth. We'll have a little bit of an abbreviated Lady Colonels post-game and then a little bit of an abbreviated Colonels pregame.
Give a little extra time, though.
Yep, well, we want to do our best to catch up with the homecoming king and queen. Get a comment from the basketball king and queen here tonight. And again, we'll kind of be in the between pregame and postgame programming on the air, but you can catch the homecoming ceremonies on our Facebook page and YouTube channel via the video stream. Kemp is trapped right in front of her own bench and has to call a timeout with 2:12 to play. Lady Colonels by 22. Back after this on WSON.
When looking for an auto mechanic, most people look for honesty and experience. Ewing Tire delivers both and offers a wide range of automotive repair services, from brakes, alignments, shocks and struts, to tire rotations and oil changes, as well as tire sales. Ewing Tire has been in business since 1964, always providing friendly service, quality work, and products. So the next time you need tires or automotive repairs, see the team at Ewing Tire, 642 North Green Street, or call 270-826-8491.
Yes. 55-33, Henderson with the lead in the basketball. The final 2:05 of the game was the Lady Colonels in control against the Union County Bravettes. The big story, the first quarter, Henderson outscored Union County 22-4, and that's been the difference ever since. Been real competitive since then. Kemp, a nice drive on the right side, and Caitlin has 10.
Yeah, the shots weren't falling very early, but they are here in the fourth.
24-point Lady Colonels lead. Kemp is the only starter on the floor for Henderson. Left side with the basketball. Hagen gets by right out, and Hagen, Maddie Hagen, with a nice game. She's got 18. 18 to lead the Bravettes, and her 18 leads all scorers. Sprinkles right baseline. Gets it to Anna Kemp underneath the basket. Anna tried to kick it back out and had it stolen away.
She to try to score.
11 turnovers for Henderson. Right side with the basketball. Morris. Now it is a jump ball, and it will go to Henderson. Kemp there to tie her up, and on the arrow, Henderson's ball. Mike Hazelwood at E.M. Ford & Company salutes Henderson County's Caitlin Kemp for the best defensive coverage tonight. Kemp has 5 steals for the best insurance coverage. Call Mike at E.M. Ford & Company, 270-830-8877. Caitlin Kemp, our defensive player of the game tonight, brought to you by Mike Hazelwood, E.M. Ford & Company. A minute to go here from Colonel Jim on homecoming night. Henderson County Lady Colonels on top of the Union County Bravettes, 57-35. Gibson bounces to Kemp. Caitlin, 17-footer, left elbow, off the mark, no good. Rebound tapped out of bounds. But last touch by Union County to stay with Henderson. Substitutes coming into the game for the Bravettes for the first time. Candace Coker and Paisley Ellman in the game. 57-35. 34 seconds left. Kemp, left elbow to Anna Kemp, high post. Inside, Brooklyn Gibson puts it up off the glass and in. The eighth grader, Gibson, 7 for her to go along with 3 rebounds. Final 20 seconds. Here the girls' game, part of a girl-boy doubleheader. The boys' game will be coming up in about 30 minutes. There will be homecoming activities between the game. And there's a near steal by Sprinkles who knocks it away. It's picked up by Kemp. And that'll do it. The Henderson County Lady Colonels knock off the Union County Bravettes 59-35, forcing 25 Bravette turnovers. The Lady Colonels move to 12-4. More importantly, 2-0 in district play. Union County drops to 11-10, 0-2 in the district. Henderson County 59, Union County 35. Our game tonight presented by United Community Bank of West Kentucky with 6 locations in Union and Webster counties to serve you. Visit UCBWest.com for more and to find the location nearest you. United Community Bank, making a difference. Savannah Lake. We'll have the scoreboard show for you. And then hear from the head coaches on the boys' side, Coach Tyler Smithart and Clay Burton, will play the boys' team coming up in about 25 minutes. So the first contest, Henderson County defeats Union County 59-35. So long for just a while here on WSON.
Play-by-play coverage of Henderson County High School basketball here on WSON has been brought to you by Owensboro Health, Henderson Chevrolet Buick GMC, Henderson County Recycling and Solid Waste, Dunaway's Imperial Pharmacy, Ewing Tire, Farmers Bank, and the Henderson County Cooperative Station Service. Henderson County basketball play-by-play here on WSON has also been brought to you by Ryan Wilkie and Walker Bruner, your local Edward Jones Investment Advisors, by Audubon Chrysler, by H&H Construction, by E.M. Ford & Company, by Heritage Federal Credit Union, and by Team Collision Center. Stay tuned for the postgame show coming up next for Henderson County High School basketball here on WSON.
Did you know that reading for 20 minutes a day exposes a person to 1.8 million words a year? Early exposure to language is the greatest factor in language development, and listening to other people read aloud is an important part of learning to read. Hello, my name is Megan Mortis, Director of Public Information for Henderson County Schools. Research shows that reading with a child every day from birth through elementary school has a lasting, positive outcome for children, families, and communities. We encourage our families to pick up a book and read together today. Inspire a love of reading.
I'm James Green, Names Manager at Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance on Zion Road.
Please help me welcome the court to the gym. Representing the freshman class, J.C. Hargis. J.C. is the daughter of Amanda and Jamie Hargis. She is a member of the cheer, team, and student council. She is escorted by Collier Petlin, the son of Jonathan and Crystal Petlin. They are sponsored by Tri-State Construction. Jackson Smith. Jackson is the son of Weston and Sarah Smith. He is a member of the football and track teams and serves on the student council. He is escorted by Blake Walker, the son of Maxon Lindsay Walker. They are sponsored by Escalade Sports. Jalen Jones. Jalen is the daughter of April Storm and the granddaughter of Shannon Chancellor. She is a member of HOSA and PLA Student Council and serves as the vice president of the freshman class. She is escorted by the future colonel, Sadie Evelyn, the daughter of Allison Evelyn and Paul Evelyn. They are sponsored by the friends and family. Carson Weiss. Carson is the son of Eli and Katrina Weiss. He is a member of FBLA and on our football, soccer, tennis, and archery teams. He is escorted by Hannah Grover, the daughter of Dan and Andy Grover. They are sponsored by Hargis ATA Martial Arts. Maddie Harris. Maddie is the daughter of Jenny Mackey and Corey Harris. She is a member of the student council and serves member of the Colonel tennis team. He is escorted by the future Colonel Holden Rideout, son of Ty and Leslie Rideout. They are sponsored by Abbott Promotions. Tess Coons. Tess is the daughter of Jack and Johnny Coons. She is a member of the cheer team. Tess is escorted by the future Colonel Coaching Watkins, the son of Kyle and Chelsea Watkins. They are sponsored by River City Services. Henry Porter. Henry is the son of Colin Porter and Renee Jack Porter. He is a member of the football team escorted by Carolyn Gish, the daughter of Michael and Beth Gish. They are sponsored by Square Yard Carpet. Elise Rawlings. Elise is the daughter of Chad Rawlings and Stephanie Berry. She is a member of the softball team. She is escorted by the future Colonel Cambry Hess, daughter of Reagan Brown and Damian Hess. They are sponsored by Tip Top. Yusuf Sonogo Kendrick. Yusuf is the son of Katie Sonogo and James Kendrick. He is a member of the football team. He is escorted by the future Colonel Kirsten Blosser, the daughter of Ben and Sherry Blosser. They are sponsored by Shaggy Chick, Groom and Board. Allison Harrison. Allison is the daughter of Jeffrey and Deanna Harrison. She is a member of the cheer team. Tonight she is escorted by the future Colonel Dylan Allender, the daughter of John and Melissa Allender. They are sponsored by Rock House on the River. Representing the junior class, Jemiah Byron. Jemiah is the daughter of Jeremy Pinkfire. She is a member of the softball team, student council, and serves as the junior class treasurer. She is escorted by her little brother and future colonel, Jaron Byron. They are sponsored by Dalton Supply and Services. Jake Rideout. Jake is the son of Brian Swiss Rideout. He is a member of the Colonel basketball team in the marketplace. Jake is escorted by the future Colonel Hudson Smithart, son of Tyler and Amy Smithart. They are sponsored by ACHS Marketplace. Mabry Rice. Mabry is the daughter of Mary and Mabry Rice. She is a member of Sonoma Student Council and serves as secretary for the junior class. She is escorted by the future Colonel Nora Coward, the daughter of Matt and Jim Coward. They are sponsored by the dance faculty. Travis Keatlin. Travis is the son of Mark and Amy Keatlin. He's a member of the football team. Colonel Brew. He is escorted by the future Colonel Jack Henry Spivar, the son of Tyler and Amy Spivar. They are sponsored by Independence Bank. Hayden Swilport. Hayden is the daughter of David and Amanda Carlin. She is a member of the cheer team, HOSA, and Colonel Brew. She is escorted by her little brother and future Colonel David Carlin Jr. They are sponsored by David Carlin, attorney at law. Zane Wolf. Zane is the son of Wayne Jr. Wolf. He is a member of SOPA. He is escorted by Brandon Robinson, the son of Billy Robinson and Sarah Lopez. They are sponsored by Dalton Supply and Services. And now, from the senior class, Carice Toons. Carice is a member of Austin Toons and Ryan Lansdale. She is a member of the soccer, basketball, and track teams in HOSA. After graduation, Carice plans to attend the University of Kentucky to major in biology. She is escorted by her cousin and future Colonel Lawton Wilson, son of Lance and Elizabeth Wilson. They are sponsored by LAW Oil Company. Brecken Sire. Brecken is the son of John and Melissa Sire. He is a member of the Colonel Football Team, Lion Club, FPOA, Colonel Crew, Leadership Dynamics, Colonel Cass News, Community Involved, National Honor Society, and a student ambassador. This fall, Brecken plans to attend the University of Southern Indiana to major in radio and television broadcasting. He is escorted by Easton Bird, son of Travis and Jennifer Bird, and they are sponsored by Kelsey G's Pizza. Haley Beck. Haley is the daughter of Ryan Cummings. She is a member of the softball team and Colonel Crew. This fall, Haley will be attending WKU Urbana State to pursue a career in the medical field. Tonight, she is escorted by Olivia Kirkwood, the daughter of Josh and Kate Kirkwood. They are sponsored by E.J. Avery Insurance Agency. Cole Parrish. Cole is the son of Leadership Dynamics and Marching Band. After graduation, Cole plans to attend the University of Kentucky to major in chemistry with a minor in biology. He is escorted by Eli Wade, the son of Jeremy and Elise Wade. They are sponsored by Silver Creek Transportation. Joe Douglas. Joe is the daughter of Sheldon and Jamie Douglas. She is a member of Conway Pass News. After graduation, Joe plans to attend Houston Community College and major in broadcast journalism. Tonight, she is escorted by JoJo Thompson, son of Akeisha Harrelson. They are sponsored by Eastgate Family Restaurant. H.P. Hazelwood. H.P. is the son of Adam John Hazelwood. He's a member of to my Neon Court. Juliana Hills. Juliana is the daughter of Stephen Crow Hills. She is a member of the Lane Crow softball team and serves as a student ambassador. This fall, Juliana will be playing softball for the University of Southern Indiana and majoring in accounting. She is escorted by Judson Pettigo, the son of Cody and Stephanie Pettigo. They are sponsored by Square Yard Carpet. Isaiah Scott. Isaiah is the son of Justin and Ashley Scott. He is a member of the Pro-Cross News and track team. After graduation, Isaiah plans to attend the University of Kentucky and major in psychology. Tonight, he is escorted by Carson Lavelle, daughter of Tyler and Lacey Lavelle. They are sponsored by Sherway East Bay. Kelsey Hill. Kelsey is the daughter of Chris Owens and Christy Hill. She is a member of the softball and volleyball teams in her recruit and serves as a student ambassador. This fall, Kelsey will be attending Georgetown College, where she will play softball and major in elementary education. Tonight, she is escorted by future Colonel Madeline Andrews, the daughter of Mark and Jennifer Andrews. They are sponsored by Luke Aesthetics. Xander Wilson. Xander is the son of Daniel and Crystal Wilson. He is a member of the basketball team and soccer teams at FBLA and Colonelsburg Bank. He is undecided on his plans this fall. Xander is escorted by his nephew and future Colonel Elite Cosby, the son of Portia Wilson and Cameron Cosby. They are sponsored by Audubon Dental. Piper Brewer. Piper is the daughter of Jack and Lori Brewer. She is a member of Sophie Student at Bachelor's and Drama Club. After high school, Piper plans to major in fine arts education either at Northern Kentucky University or Murray State. Tonight, she is escorted by future Colonel Carson Brewer, the son of Avery Elbert. They are sponsored by Audubon Metals. Peyton Nimick. Peyton is the son of Alan and Diane Nimick. He is a member of Student at Bachelor's. After graduation, Peyton plans to attend the University of Kentucky to major in biology. He is escorted by future Colonel Anna Forbes, the daughter of Sean and Nancy Forbes. They are sponsored by Christy Moore, ERA First Advantage. Assisting with tonight's crowning is the 2021 basketball homecoming king and queen, David Kidd and Brenna Stacer. David is the son of Kevin and Melissa Kidd and attends Murray State University, majoring in social studies education. And now, the moment we have all been waiting for. Your 2022 basketball homecoming king and queen, Isaiah Scott and Julian Hills.
Are
Seth Hibbs and Carol Hibbs.
Justin and Ashley Scott.
Were you surprised that you won?
A little bit, yes.
No, man, I'm a people's champion.
Tell us what you plan on doing. I know big-time softball player here. What you plan on doing and where you're going?
I'm going to University of Southern Indiana to play softball and major in accounting.
I'm going to UK, and I'm studying psychology.
All right, last thing. You want to give a shout-out to anybody? Here's your chance.
My mom, she's amazing.
Shout out to Tommy Red.
And Justin Pettigo, he's the best little walker what there is.
All right, guys. Congratulations. All right, back to you, Greg.
Thank you, Scotty. Our homecoming king and queen, Isaiah Scott and Juliana Hibbs, here at Henderson County High School basketball homecoming king and queen for 2022. Lady Colonel is just now getting into the locker room, so we'll try to maybe get a word with